I heard that.
Woo!
Ready?
You've heard from the nice guys. Now it's all this.
Thank you.
happening. A crack plaster smiles and you listen. True incompetence, indulging weakness. Satan can't budge as you listen. Eyes that shine through the sparkling wine. Baby, alone, there's nobody home as you listen. Low tongue talk and small house talk. You gape in style and you walk. Essays in truth, firm conviction. Unconvinced as you walk. Eyes that shine through the sparkling wine. Baby, alone, there's nobody home. For other reasons, misunderstood, and you move. Maybe tomorrow, see without sorrow. Oblivious as you move. Eyes that shine through the sparkling wine. Alone,
by the Blue Orchids. That's about the response I expected. We've been working on a record for about 13 years. And it's done, I swear. But we had an argument over the artwork, so we didn't actually get it in time for the show. But that's typical of us, so. But it's all covers. So the first thing was a Pell Mell song, if you're old enough to remember Pell Mell. And then the Blue Orchids was a fall spin-off band. This should be a little more obvious, I hope.
Response was Thank you.
Good luck, everybody.
There's a light in the sky. Oh me, oh my, there's a light in the sky.
It's 77, a light shone from our hearts and from our minds. We looked into the ethers and saw that they were very much alive. The songs that they were leading us to find a higher energy.
That's right. Oh, me, oh, my, there's a light in the sky. Oh, me, oh, my, there's a light in the sky. Oh, me, oh, my, there's a light in the sky. Oh, me, oh, my, there's a light in the sky.
The flying saucers are real.
All right, that was a Steve Hillage song. Another thing I'm sure each and every one of you has a Steve Hillage record, right?
I personally know some Steve Hillage fans out there, man.
Watch out!
Yeah, watch out. Yeah.
And is anybody surprised by that statement from you?
goody, in anticipation of the Pope. We're trying out a lot of stuff tonight that we've never actually played before, as you can see. That was one. This is a really old song that we haven't played in about 20 years, but we whipped it out, and we find it amusing. We hope you do, too.
Or at least keep you away.
Chris is still in Australia time, right? What time is it in Australia, Chris?
Who cares?
Who the fuck cares, right? Got another beer, huh?
Beer,
sir.
All right.
It's like that, isn't it?
A marble and wheel, copper and steel, wild town and its luck, a grimacing trunk, he spins his axes on top of the table, espousing his views from million rooms, and they come to you how your contempt is renewed. Thought running here makes me see all too clear how unlike everyone I can remember I knew. Traps, supply and demand, mathematics and facts, computed reveal, the secrets conceal, displaced in this day, the ways of an A, a hideous scheme, horizons of steel.
Tyrone's man lost in my neighborhood on streets I know very well. Wandering aimlessly, wavering endlessly, leaving today for the next town that gets in the way.
To speak, I struggle to reach that tone in your voice, the onset of fear, it spins like the world, as is everything near, just from breathing these air.
My point of view locked in a waiting room where we have smothered desire, in a notebook whose heartstrings sing out to you, coming to terms with the slow, spiteful passing of you.
It's alive.
Key line of the song was taken from an Abraham Lincoln speech that I heard while watching PBS Stoned, probably, in about 1990, when I was itinerantly employed as a musician. which I did a lot, both the pot and the musician thing. Picture discs. We have a couple of old copies of CDs that Jonathan found in his basement. I'll give us a plug now. This weekend we're going to do a festival in Southern California called the Camp Grand Beethoven Campout. So if anybody feels like doing a road trip, I'm driving down tomorrow, as a matter of fact. But it's Camper and Cracker and the Monks of Doom, and see who else. Johnny Hickman's gonna play some solo stuff. Greg and Jonathan and I are gonna play solo stuff. Emmerich's gonna make peace with our record company by playing with our A&R guy. That's true, actually. That's not a joke. He's a sellout because he's the, we were like, well, who can play with Stephen Brower? And like, I know Emmy can do it because he sold out. He sold his soul to the devil, as you all know.
Anybody see him on the Oscars? He was playing a white Les Paul. He never plays with his band. It looked very, he had gold trim or something. Was it a Hugo Boss suit or was it Gucci?
I didn't sell out, Victor. I bought in.
So next time we have this discussion about property taxes, then I hope you will.
We want to thank the Ward Brothers very much for playing tonight. And Sensations, fantastic live music. And thank you very much for staying and listening to us. We really appreciate it.
We do appreciate it.
And this is dedicated to the bands that came before us. All 5 million of them.
We'll be right back.
Bert Jantz song. Played probably not like Bert Jantz would ever play it, but. We, of course, can't do Fleetwood Mac, much like Fleetwood Mac would play it. So.
Yeah.
Why?
I like Fleetwood Mac, which should be apparent by any of you who've known my career. I mean, actually, that was Jonathan's fault. I would have done Then Play On, but Jonathan and David wanted to do Tusk. And they're stronger than I am, or more strong-willed than I am, I should say. How's it going over there? That's a new experience for you, tuning your own guitar, yeah? I love him, you know, I'm allowed to do that. I've known him for a while, you know, and we've gone through ups and downs, but we mostly get along, so I'm allowed to give my friend shit once in a while.
And I like getting my hands dirty with the little people.
I'm sure nobody in this audience has ever given him. Thanks, I'm glad you're slumming it today, it's nice. I mean, I'm sure nobody here has ever given David a hard time.
Never. Take this. We'll be right back.
Tearing Frenzy.
Tearing Frenzy.
Hot Nights.
It'll be hotter in the desert.
Yes.
Out of my air conditioned bodysuit.
How much is that? Can I get one? All right.
I got an endorsement.
Yeah. Ready?
To cast this demon out and convalesce my burns. I'm gonna convalesce my burns. And when I finally heal, I'm gonna scatter ashes, memories in the dust. Memories in the dust. And I'll forget you. I'll forget you. One day I won't recall your name. I won't forgive you. I'm gonna take it to my grave. In the blessed heat, my memory starts to fail. I can put some time between you and me. Watch the whitewash on the wall bead with sweat and start to fall and crumble to the earth. It's gonna crumble to the earth. And you'll forget me. You'll forget me. One day you won't recall my face. I won't forgive you. I'm gonna take it to my grave. Milagro per acquita te la corazon, la corazon. Calaveras, potemas comer. Un milagro per acquita te la corazon, calaveras, potemas comer. To cast this demon out and isolate my pain. I'm gonna isolate my pain. And when I finally do, I'm gonna cut that part from me and throw it to the dogs. I'm gonna throw it to the dogs. Open all the doors and shake out all the carpets and go from room to room with burning sage. With blinders for my eyes and a steel blade across my heart to protect me from your brilliant disguises. And I'll forget you. I'll forget you. One day I won't recall your name. Potemas comer. Un milagro para quitarte la corazón, calaveras, potemas comer. Un milagro para quitarte la corazón, calaveras, potemas comer. Thank you.
I was wondering just where this road would take us. It's the same one that we have been on. From the city of Basra to Jerusalem, from the west into the finally get us all some peace. And behind the man behind the curtain is working, pulling levers by his crystal ball.
See the city consumed by fire.
And I was thinking 16 years is wrong, it's probably more like 18 or 19, but it's ironic that we wind up playing to about the same amount of people in the same general geographic location on Market Street in San Francisco.
We still love you! Yeah!
And I love each and every one of you too.
Victor, it's only 3D.
Yeah, I know it's only 3D, Crimson. I have my contacts in. That's Australian humor. It's different. He got his citizenship. Like, what was that last week? How long ago they give you the passport?
2 weeks.
2 weeks. Give him. You know, he's an Australian now. Come on. In this world,
shall we all be?
In this world, there. That's something to be proud of. I think.
Good on ya.
All right, check this one. I swear to you, this new record will be out sometime, October-ish, probably. And with that,
Ripley's!
The
Traveler!
Ripley's!
Yeah!
Thank God! Yeah, Ripley's! Come on. Sorry.
Thank God!
Who said that?
Not embarrassing.
You can't impress him. Come on.
We don't mean this, what we're about to do, but we're doing it anyway.
Ready?
Yeah.
Thank you very much. It's David Immerglick over on the guitar there. Chris Peterson on the drums. Greg Lasher over here on the other guitar.
Victor, the Reverend Krumenacher.
Thank you for coming down. We really appreciate it.
It's a time machine. And it's not pretty.
Consulting with our fashion person right now. So just,
Woo!
Woo!
Be people.
That was a band. Be music.
I saw the Be People open for New Order in 1981.
No, that was Bee Team.
No, it was the Be People.
Bee Movie.
It was Paul Cutler, who went on to be in 45 Grave and some other people. Time and Place, Los Angeles, 1981, Perkins Palace in Pasadena.
Sorry.
It's all right. New Order weren't really very good. The Beat People were actually better. We tried. Not bad for a bunch of something aged fucks that we are.
I saw Genesis do The Lamb Lies Down on Broadway at the Berklee Community Theater. Ow. 1973, maybe? Best mic drums I've heard.
Greg, what you got?
Yeah, Greg, come on. I'm also, he's got Day on the Green, 1979, I know that.
Well, Greg's got AC/DC Hell's Bells Tour.
Yeah, that's a lot better than my stepmom taking me to Steve Flew with that.
Neil Diamond.
No, I never saw Neil Diamond.
Chris doesn't like music, so he's actually never been to a concert.
Chris saw Zeppelin. Did you see Zeppelin or did you know?
Like most drummers.
Yeah, Chris saw Zeppelin.
Black box.
I turned to you, but you packed up and left me that day. Not even a note, you just run away. I dragged myself up to the hill. I thought you were dead, so I burned a candle and I prayed that it couldn't be true.
Dangerous on that one.
When Chris actually did see Led Zeppelin, he went to the boys' bathroom during the drum solo, surprisingly. And there were like 30 guys wearing Skinner t-shirts in a circle puking. And he told us that story, and we wrote this song.
Thanks very much. I know some of you came a long way to see it. We appreciate it. Come down to Southern California if you want. We'll be there all weekend.
Cheers, big ears.